Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond, Jerry Goble and State Farm Insurance, Richmond, Express Roofing, we've got you covered, expressroofing.net, Cumberland Valley National Bank in Richmond and Berea, Luxury Pet Services in Richmond, Time Warner Cable, Equipment Sales and Rentals, Madison County Schools, Tatum Enterprises, and Real Life Community Church, myrealchurch.org.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby.
Hello everyone, welcome to Alumni Coliseum on the campus of Eastern Kentucky University. Boys basketball, first round district action about to tip off. The Berea Pirates and the Madison Southern Eagles about to get it underway. Berea comes in with a record of 8 wins, 19 losses against the Eagles, who are 17 wins, 13 losses, coming off a heartbreaker on senior night the other night, as you saw on Madison County School Sports Television against Frankfort. Don Foster, Doug Sally will have the action, as both teams have played each other. Now they've played each other twice already. Does that really come into effect for Berea now? Do you know, it's hard to beat a team three times, they say.
It is. They know each other. You know what? There are no secrets in this game. There may be some different strategy that's used tonight, but as far as personnel and the basic concept, each coach knows what the other one's going to do. And you know, Southern's won one of the games by 24 and the other game by 22. So, you know, Berea's going to have to pull a major upset tonight if they're going to win this one.
Berea's going to have to find that Hoosier moment, if you will, to come and get the victory in this one. Quickly, for the Pirates, DeAndre Tate, Shaheem Alexander, Dalton Gadd, Derek Castle, and Caleb Flowers are your starters. Eagles, usual lineup. Caleb Miller, Michael Jefferson, Tanner Kidwell, Stacey Burns, and Griffin Gabbard.
And both teams starting four seniors and a junior each. So this is the last go-around for these guys if they don't get it done tonight.
You know, this is my second favorite day of the basketball season after the opening practice, the first day of districts. Everybody's 0-0. Don't matter if you're 8-19. You have as much of a chance as Central or Trinity or anybody. Everybody's zeros.
Well, Bree is opening up in a little 1-2-2 zone. Left the corner
back
open.
Backside, though. Nobody get on Burns. Stacy with the glass and the basket.
Well, that's a weakness coming out of that 1-2-2. You know, the weak side guard's got to drop down and protect that weak side rebound and drop all the way to the baseline, and didn't do it that time.
Bree so, gets it across. Trapping, though.
So they're in a half-court trap.
All the way for Jefferson.
Good start.
4-0. And Mr. Jackson said, I've seen all I can take. Cameron Jackson with the quick 30, 27 seconds into the ball game.
Well, that's what you call a scared timeout right there.
Yeah, boy.
Because you don't want this game to get away too quick. You know, your kids have been hit right in the nose to start off. So,
James got across half court. Yeah, they just barely got across half court and had it knocked away.
Well, the key for tonight's matchup, according to Coach Jackson, is taking care of the basketball. They cannot turn it over. They've had that trouble all year. And Southern's going to try to up-tempo. They're going to try to trap. They're going to open up probably in a man-to-man press all over the floor and look for their opportunities. And Berea's got to take care of it if they want to have any kind of shot tonight.
7:23 in the opening quarter. And it's 4-0 Southern. Wanted to clear out, but as soon as you clear out, you're going to get trapped. Get in that corner.
Rough place to handle it.
Well, two possessions, two turnovers for the Pirates. Number 15, DeAndre Tate for Berea, was an All-State honorable mention football player this past season.
Well, they've got a couple athletes in the lineup. And
they'll curl off the screen. Turnover for Kidwell. Try to make something that wasn't there.
Yeah, nice little interior screen there, and they ran a little curl, like you said, and Tanner just lost control there. So they're doing a good job in their man-to-man.
Yeah, Berea's
been very
patient.
Deliberate.
They've been patient.
And this is this plays right up to their game plan. You know, they'll try to take the air out of the ball a little bit.
Best chance they have in it to slow the tempo.
We're running a little triangle delay here on top where on the pass across, you have a screen going to.
Oh, almost a turnover.
They'll screen the man on the foul line. Let's see if they get lined back up.
Foul. Foul is going to go against Miller.
You know, the ideal possession for Berea right now, run a minute off the clock, take a shot, hit it, get back in their zone, pack it in. And that'd be the way they'd like to play all night. A little screener action there on the out of bounds.
Yep, Clarence has it. He gives it up to Castle. Back to Tate. Castle shot. Might have walked, no call.
Yeah, look what I found.
Like a travel.
Yeah, look what I found. He kind of got up in the air and didn't know what to do with it. Threw it off the glass and got a basket.
Miller's going to throw it to the backcourt. Turnover, but the Berea Pirates have it high off the glass. No, Burns got it. Clarence went high off the glass. See?
Well, that foul took a layup away from Southern. So it wasn't a bad foul in the backcourt there.
Foul on 42.
It's Gadd, isn't it?
Yes.
Dalton Gadd.
One of the seniors for Dalton Gadd. And back in that 1-2-2. 5.5 to play, opening quarter.
Running Burns off the baseline and then a little curl for Kidwell in the lane.
Jefferson all the way. It's fouled. It's going to go on Tate. I believe number 30.
Let's see who they gave it to. I think he got fouled twice.
Oh, 42. Yeah. That's two on Gadd.
Yeah. Well, we saw this in the girls' game.
Yeah.
They had one of the players, the standard for girl, had quick foul trouble. And
yeah, she had three by 4 minutes ago in the opening quarter.
Yeah, with 5:16 to go, you got two fouls already. So that throws a little wrench in the game plan.
Jefferson misses the free throw. Can't have a Madison Southern boys basketball game, it seems like, without mentioning free throws.
We're going to be on that subject again. You know, Southern only shoots 10% better from the free throw line than they do from the field. They shoot 58% from the free throw line all year.
Michael's a 63% free throw shooter.
A little bit better on that one.
1-0-2. 5-2, Southern up. 5:16 in the quarter. Tate gets it. Over to Alexander.
Interesting matchup there. Jefferson on Alexander.
Three ball up and good for Tate.
That'll help your confidence right there.
We are tied at 5 with 5 to play. Nice drive from Michael on the floor. Both officials had the foul. That one will go against 31. Baker. 31 replaced.
Replaced Gadd.
He replaced Gadd. Thank you.
Man to man still by Southern. Not really putting an extreme amount of pressure on the ball, but
they come
with
the
trap.
Double.
He walked.
He shuffled his feet, didn't he? Power shuffled, but he gets the basket.
A little teardrop there.
Berea takes her first lead of the ball game at 7-5. Berea's coaching staff is up and excited.
Southern just got to stay patient, stay with their knitting, do what they do.
Kidwell corner, Burns for a three. No. Backside rebound by Jefferson. No. Quails comes out with it, gives it up.
Wow.
Arching rainbow. Couldn't be handled by 21.
And he was out of control there and didn't get bailed out this time. Well, they had the weak side rebound if he just could have handled it.
Didn't know if Kid Wolf was flexing or calling a play.
Well, pass deflected.
Taken away by Castle. Tate all the way to the basket. Up and foul. No. No foul. Southern ball.
You know, Alexander made a great move in there to the lane and just didn't capitalize.
Sargent in the ball game, placing Tanner Kidwell.
Well, Sargent's noted for his three-point shooting.
That's what I was thinking when he came in, maybe to
a little bit better shooter than Tanner. And if Bree's going to stay in his zone, then they're going to have to hit a couple shots from the outside.
That's Aaron Miller time. Yes! Miller with a basket. Makes it 8-7. So you shoot it. You got to shoot a team out of the zone.
Yeah, if they're going to pack it in, you've got to make them play honest. And
Bree, trap. Almost a turn. It is a turnover. Miller has it. Lost it. Picked back up.
Great hustle.
Bodies everywhere.
That's what you like to see, guys going on the floor.
Boys, it's one and done here. You go home after this one.
Good job by Tate there, just kind of slowing it up.
Showed it, lost it, fouled. He was bailed out. Or I didn't see the foul. Wasn't bailed out, but I didn't see the foul, really.
Yeah, he got fouled. He was trying to fake that pass and get his shot. They caught it on the floor.
Foul on Gabbard. It's his first.
Well, Southern's had some players have a tendency to get in foul trouble this year. They've had a...
Gabbard's one of them.
Several games in the first half, you know, they've had to sit players down. And
Griffith's been one to get in foul trouble.
Yeah, he was in trouble against Frankfurt the other night.
Yes.
Well, they've really spread it out here this time.
5 second call. Larry Lewis with the call.
I was getting ready to say, you know, you got that 6 foot guarding distance. If you're within 6 foot of the ball handler,
yep.
Then you can. Get that 5 second count. Still in high school. College took that away, which I think was a big mistake.
Yeah, I don't. Well, I like that call.
Miss Gabbard wide open.
Yeah, twice. Gabbard's running that baseline. Miller for another three. No. Tate with the board.
Well, he's got some hops to him. You know, he can go up in the crowd and get the rebound.
He's a big old boy, isn't he? 8-7, 2:17 to play. Southern on top of Berea. You know, that timeout he took might have been the key. He settled him down after being down 4-0.
Good steal there by Jefferson, giving a good weak Michael side.
All the way to the basket. 5 points for Michael.
You know, it's a battle of wills. You know, who's gonna be able to exert their will on the other team? Berea wants to slow up the tempo. Uh-oh. Southern wants to speed it up.
And one for Alexander, but the basket does not fall.
He made a good and strong move to the basket. Didn't get the roll, but really aggressive taking that ball to the basket. That may be the one matchup that they feel like they can attack tonight is whoever's guarding Alexander, because he's so strong physically.
You said Alexander's one of their better ball players.
Yeah, he's done a great job for me. They ask him to do a lot. You know, you can see him down here handling the ball against the press, and you know, he plays inside defensively, and he'll post up, but he'll also step out on the three-point line and hit you a shot out there sometimes.
DeAndre Dean has checked in, replacing Griffin Gabbard from Madison Southern.
Good touch there from the free throw line. Let's see what Berea's in this time. And it does look like they're in a box of one chasing Sargent.
Yeah, they're not going to let Sargent get loose. Burns for another three. No, way off the mark. 10-9. Again, like we talked in the girls' game, if you watched the girls' game earlier, first round district jitters.
Yeah, you have to say so. And you know, Berea's done a good job attacking and being patient, picking their spots to attack.
Sargent with a rebound.
And they're going to make Southern beat them from the outside. Here's the play right here.
Look at Michael.
Here's the thing right there. Open court game favors Southern heavily. Yes. If they can get the ball off the boards and beat them in transition, or being able to force some turnovers and score out of their defense, then that's going to be the game right there.
7 points for Jefferson.
And we look at the trap.
He showed it, drove, and ran him over.
Ooh.
Dean with the block.
Yeah, he got there, just didn't get his body squared up.
He didn't get there in
time, did he? Yeah, just didn't get his body squared up. Good effort.
A fourth team foul on Madison Southern.
Kidwell back in.
Kidwell in, and 21.
Flowers.
31 Sandberg, Sandberg 31. Steal by Miller. 42 seconds in the opening quarter.
Good pass.
Miller can't finish.
Nice
but
tip.
Michael was there, couldn't finish. Dean, the athlete, with the putback.
Yeah, nice finish with his left hand there in traffic.
That's
good
tough.
Good job attacking the glass there by Madison Southern.
14-9, 24 seconds. On the way, kick. Foul on the floor once again.
Two on Dean already.
Two on Dean, quick. Seems like Southern post players are always in foul trouble.
Well, they're doing a lot of reaching. You know, you got to move your feet, get your body there, and when you're trying to reach on a ball handler, you're taking a big gamble.
Because that's going to be two on him and two on Dean now.
Let's see if Bria waits for one shot here. You would think that they would try to. Well, that's a
floater.
That's a bad shot
that's
right there.
Shot.
Now you got Southern on
it's
the way.
It's a four-point swing if he makes it. He can't make it, but.
Yeah, but he's going to the line. You just don't want that shot down here on the other end. You got within 5 points. You wait for one shot. If you hit it, you know, you're within two or three.
That's right. If not,
now you're looking at a, you know,
possible swing.
Six or seven-point deficit. Here's Tanner. Let's see what he does on the free throw line. I'm not going to say anything.
Kosh Patel is getting ready to check in. Replace Dean. Dean's out. Patel in.
Well, Dean with those two fouls, so Patel's going to have to play some minutes here. Give him a break.
Kidwell misses both.
With 5 seconds to go. See if they get a shot.
That's a foul. Didn't blow, no foul out of bounds. Kidwell shooting 46% from the free throw line. That's just.
We talk about that every game.
The epitome of in your head.
Let's see if they send Tate long here for the touchdown pass. So they got Alexander.
He had it and lost it. You know, they were looking for Tate to get that three up.
Yeah, well, Alexander actually is the one that went for the ball there. I thought they might throw a lob there to Tate because he's got such a high vertical, can go in traffic and catch it.
14-9 after one. Southern leads it. It's a close one. Back for the second quarter after this. Time out.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond, Jerry Goble and State Farm Insurance in Richmond, Express Roofing, we've got you covered, expressroofing.net, Cumberland Valley National Bank in Richmond and Berea, Luxury Pet Services in Richmond, Time Warner Cable, Equipment Sales and Rentals, Madison County Schools, Tatum Enterprises, and Real Life Community Church, My Real Church.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby.
Back to Alumni Coliseum, campus of Eastern Kentucky University. Second quarter about to get underway. Berea throws it by five, and as they inbound the ball.
David Gadd in the lineup, number 10 for Berea.
Sean Short as well in for Massa Southern. Three ball way off the mark. Looking ahead, Kidwell.
Nice.
Oh! Kosh can't finish. Gets it And one.
He was on that three-point play.
He saw Lanham in that goals game. He's going to pad his offensive rebounding stats as well.
That was a pretty pass by Tanner Kidwell, though. It hit him right on the run. He knew exactly where he was before he caught the ball.
Nice job to finish, though, once he got the ball back.
He stayed with it. You know, didn't give up on the play, so credit to him for that.
Tate. The foul was on DeAndre Tate. It was his first. As Patel finishes the three-point play, Eagles up 17-9.
2-2-1, three-quarters. See how hard they trap out of this. Good two passes right there.
Shot is up and good.
You know, I think Southern can live with that shot because it's shot quick, and they want the up-tempo. They'll give up a shot on the first pass just to keep this tempo up.
Miller time. Yes. Caleb with his second three of the game. Turnover, Berea.
Nice pass.
Miller, basket.
Well, let's see how long Coach Jackson can wait here. You got an 11-point game now.
I thought he was going to take one there.
Yeah, I did too.
Foul on Jefferson.
Well, you got to admire Tate right there for being patient, pulling him back out. He had a little opportunity to shoot that ball and so now we need to slow this thing back down again.
Michael's first. Team six, so three is in the bonus. Foul on the floor. Bonus.
Got Patel there. That might be a matchup they can exploit.
Yes.
If they pull Patel away from the basket a little bit to see if Coach Buttry sticks with his man-to-man. Or at least with that matchup.
I was wondering, I was going to say, would they go zone?
You know, they could with him in there. And you know, you just wonder about Patel's lateral movement and if he can stay with these guys from Berea.
Tate with the free throw. 4 points now for Tate. Makes it a 9-point ball game, 22-13.
Looks like they're staying in that 1-2-2.
They're
going to stay
in that zone, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they're going to pack it in. They can't afford to get out and pressure Southern. They don't have the depth to do it, and they don't have the matchups defensively. Nice pass inside.
Looked low to Patel. Good.
Now, it's interesting that they put a guard, Jefferson, there in the high post area, but he's a playmaker. He's a guy that can get in there. He can make good passes, good decisions. He can also attack the basket from that position.
Kidwell to flex out of bounds.
Good anticipation there. As long as he didn't break his finger.
Yeah, really. Alexander shows it.
Well, Southern's in the zone now. They're in a 2-3. Yep. They looked the trap out of it up front there just a second ago.
All up and no good. Kidwell. Corner. One more time for Miller. In and out. Offensive glass over Patel. No. Jefferson cleans it up, though.
Thought Patel got fouled on that first one there, but attacking the glass well, and you know, Berea can't afford to give up those opportunities. Lee Walk. David Gadd, one of the region's best tennis players.
Yeah.
He's been in the state tournament in doubles a couple times already, and he's just a sophomore. So, this is his second sport.
Miller triggers inbound to Kidwell.
Looks like we got boxing one again. Looks like they're chasing Miller Caleb. This time. Yeah, that opened up the gap. Tanner did a good job.
Yep. Nice take.
Yeah, he recognized that right away.
Kidwell's in the board now with 2 points. ...28-13, Southern leads it. 5 minutes to play before the half. Alexander wants to clean it out. Gets the tail one-on-one.
There's a matchup, yep.
Tate, no.
Good rebound by Jefferson. He's a wiry kid, you know.
He is.
He doesn't look that strong, but he goes in traffic and does a good job.
Patel, Michael, three ball, short, long.
Well, that's not his game. I think he's only shooting 16% from the three-point line this year. But it looks good, you know, when he releases.
It looks nice. Yeah, it's not like he's...
doesn't have a funky release or anything, yeah. You know. His dad, Craig, is over on the bench as an assistant coach, and you know he's had the coaching coming up as he's grown up.
That was on Kidwell, his first.
Burns in for Miller. Coach Buttry's going to his bench early and often here, try to keep everybody fresh.
Peyton missed it front end. 15-point advantage for the Eagles.
Straight 2-3 this time.
Long jumper in and out. Patel cleans it up. No, he misses. Short with the offensive glass, and they're going to get Patel over the back.
They did. You know, if you're going to live with a foul, that's one you can live with.
Yes.
Being aggressive on the offensive boards. I never did complain.
Nope.
Unless a kid was already in foul trouble.
That's a good aggressive foul. You know, it's hustle foul.
That's right. And, you know, you can't complain too much about that.
Sergeant in. He's going to replace Patel.
And now you've got basically
four
guards and a forward. Let's give Burns credit for being a forward.
To the line is Tate. Cuts the lead in half now, 28-14.
You'd expect Southern to drop into some type of zone defense again, 2-3. It'll be interesting to see if they feel comfortable enough with their size out there to match up man-to-man against Berea.
Tate now with 7 points, leading the way for Berea as Coach Jackson takes a full timeout at the 4:16 mark. 28-15, Southern leads. Timeout on the floor. We'll take it with them. Back after this. Yeah, I looked up, it's 28-14, you know. It's like it should be closer than that.
Yeah, the pace of the game is
thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond, Jerry Goble and State Farm Insurance, Richmond, Express Roofing, we've got you covered, expressroofing.net, Cumberland Valley National Bank in Richmond and Berea, Luxury Pet Services in Richmond, Time Warner Cable, Equipment Sales and Rentals, Madison County Schools, Tatum Enterprises, and Real Life Community Church, My Real Church.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby.
Back on Alumni Coliseum with the Eagles are triggered the inbounds. 4-3 in turnovers.
Yeah.
4 minute mark.
Bria's going straight man to man this possession.
Further.
First time they come out of the zone. Nice penetration and kick.
Burns with the basket.
Good finish there by Stacy Burns.
4 points now for Stacy, and the Eagles go full man. Right to Michael, basket.
Somebody needs to tell Alexander he can run a baseline after a score. He's not really improving his passing angle there by standing still.
There, Eagles trap at half court. Stay in it. Steps called, turnover. Fourth turnover for Berea. One of the biggest glaring stats on the stat sheet. Southern 20 points in the paint. Two for Berea.
You know, they've done a great job on the offensive glass down here. You know, getting
that's where it comes from.
Second chance points. There's that curl move again out of the zone.
Short underneath, reverse layup, good.
Nice English on that. Good. Good job there, young fella.
You know you're going good when that falls.
Castle really struggling against this pressure. They may have to get another
timeout.
Turn
that back. Timeout. He called. He's asking.
Yeah, he was calling timeout. They didn't see it. Should have given it up. Yeah, he got it.
Give it up late. Kidwell will go to the line for two.
Just a hair late on that pass. Coach Jackson was begging for a timeout there. They knew that 10-second count was about to get called.
Referee's about to give it to him as the Brea player threw it. We have a contact lens lost.
Well, if they do.
Not quite sure what he's.
They're looking for something on the floor,
yes,
there, I
they're
believe.
Looking for something on the floor.
They've all been walking over in that area, so you wonder.
I don't know.
They may have some blood on the floor. I think that's
what it
is.
That's what it is. Trainer comes out with the cleaning pad.
Yeah. Reminds me of when I was a head coach down at Southern. We had a kid get hurt and blood was on the floor. Coach Chris was on my staff. And I asked him to go in and get the blood kit out of the coach's office.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not doing that. I might get AIDS.
Might catch some back in. You know, we didn't know how this stuff really went, you know.
He didn't want to put those gloves on, even touch it with the gloves. It was so funny.
Funniest thing we had, I was coaching Jenny Vorbeck, one of our big centers. She got bloody, and I went and got her, you know, ran the locker room, got another jersey for her. She wanted to take her jersey off on the bench and put it back on. I'm like, whoa, you can't do that. Let's go around the corner.
Yeah.
She was the top player, though, who did not want to come out of the game. She did not want to come out of the game. But she just wanted to get back in as quick as possible.
Yeah, I never had to deal with those situations. I always coached the boys.
I'm like, whoa. But she was one of the most aggressive players I was ever around.
I thought Tanner had him a free throw there for a second. Hit every part of the rim, but didn't go in.
But 34-15, Southern leads it. And he finally gets one. 35-15, 20-point advantage. 2:43 before the half.
Good job by Sergeant there. Moving
Sergeant cut him off. Jackson. Or Tate, that's Tate, I'm sorry.
And he did a good job, everything but the finish. Alexander couldn't clean it up.
Miller to the corner. Sergeant sets. Shot. Yes.
Well, that'd give him a little bit of confidence. And he's a little streaky, you know. He can get hot. He can hit two or three in a row, or he can go the other way sometimes.
Sergeant averages 6 points a ball game on the season.
Good trap.
Again, watch your 10-second count. They break it, get it across. It's been a while since Brea has scored.
Yeah, Castle a little out of control there. He did a good job breaking the pressure, and you know, he got it up and beat the 10-second count.
Fell on Nath's going to go against the Eagles. It's on Sergeant. On Miller, number five.
Noah Marshall coming in the lineup here.
21-6 this quarter for Madison Southern. They are pulling away.
Yeah, all of your game plan is out the window now if you're Berea. When you're down 22 already, you know, a slow pace is not going to get you back in the game. You got to go ahead and play.
It said Marshall in 14. The junior. And at the line is Tate. And he makes the second. 38-17. Tate now with 4 points. Fire! 15 is Alexander, not Tate. I had Tate on the brain.
There's a little inside screen there. They're doing a good job executing that. You see Kentucky run that sometimes against his own. They'll pick that middleman and curl the
Kidwell
player.
Stacy layup.
Nice pass by Kidwell. You know, that's the thing he does.
Very nice look.
That's the thing he does the best. You know, he is a really excellent passer.
And they're going to get short for riding him down the floor.
Minute 23 to go, 40-17.
Double bonus now for Berea. Castle to the line. Winner of this game advances to Friday night's championship game. Plays the winner of Madison Central Model.
Yeah, you got Madison Central be a clear-cut favorite in that game.
Michael Jefferson back in, replacing Sean Short from Madison Southern.
Model's had their moments, though. They've played some good basketball during the course of the season.
Model has Tony, or how do you say his name?
Oyento.
Oh, yeah.
Oriento, he only had 42 against Southern.
That's right,
this year,
and Alex Chin.
And almost beat him by himself. Yeah, Chin is an excellent
That's
rebounder.
That's right, Model beat Madison Southern at Madison Southern earlier this season.
Central's playing so well. Nice up and under, good patience there by Tanner.
He showed it, put it up, and gets the basket. 5 points now for Tanner. As we go under a minute to play before the half.
He walked.
Yeah.
Larry Lewis on the call there, the veteran. He used to call my JV games when I was a JV coach back in Clark County. He's been around forever. That tells you how old he is and how old I am.
Good. If you've coached in the 11th, you have a Larry Lewis story.
Yeah, 10th or 11th, you know, the Bluegrass Association covers both those regions.
Some stories are left better unsaid.
I'm just wondering what he's putting on his hair so he doesn't show the age. We'll have to ask him at halftime. I was hoping he could hear me just now.
Southern
waiting for one shot here.
15 seconds are going to trigger probably around the 10-second mark. And we're at the 9, 8. Jefferson has it. 6 to 5. It's going to be a long three ball up. And good. Sergeant. That's how the half ends on a three-point basket.
Well, that's a morale killer right there. You're already down that bad.
45-19 Southern on top. Let's go to Samantha Burford, as she will be with Coach Shane Buckley.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond, Jerry Goble and State Farm Insurance, Richmond, Express Roofing, we've got you covered, expressroofing.net, Cumberland Valley National Bank in Richmond and Berea, Luxury Pet Services in Richmond, Time Warner Cable, Equipment Sales and Rentals, Madison County Schools, Tatum Enterprises, and Real Life Community Church, myrealchurch.org.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby.
All right, Coach, first game of the district tournament. You seem to be making it work and down the paint in the middle.
Yeah, we're taking advantage of some things they do defensively. We were prepared for their zone. We knew they had to zone us. I'm proud of our defense, though. I know we've given up 19 points, but they've only hit three shots. The rest of them have been free throws, but touchy fouls. We're playing solid defense. If we give up three field goals and a half, we're doing our job.
Seems like you brought in number three, Sergeant, to hit the threes.
Yeah, if they're zone, he's a zone buster. And when he comes in, that's what he's supposed to do is light it up. So
you got some nice assists from Tanner Kidwell.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of distributing the ball. When we make extra passes, we're a really good team.
Great. Good luck, Coach.
Appreciate it. Thanks.
Welcome back to second half action. About to get underway. Madison Southern will be inbounding. Halftime, 45-19, Southern on top. Key stats of the game early on, 13 turnovers for the Pirates to only 4 for Madison Southern. Madison Southern shooting at a 60% clip, where the Pirates are hitting at 27%. That is the key in the game right there.
Well, you got the one thing that Coach Jackson was concerned about, taking care of the basketball.
Yes.
You got 13 turnovers, and several of those led to points. And Southern's hit the three. They're 4 out of 10, 40% from the three. And Berea's starting out man-to-man here this half.
Like you heard Coach Butker said, half, you know, defense been playing really well.
Ran a little lob, back screen lob there for Gabbard. Went up and got it. And one thing I liked about that is he didn't try to shoot it up in the air.
No, he came down.
He came down, gathered himself, and went up and got it.
Berea with only three made field goals in the opening half.
Yeah, they've done a good job defensively. Tate's got 7 points. It's their leading scorer. And Jefferson's got 11 for Southern, and that's Southern's leading scorer.
Gabbard with the rebound. Going to get the foul on Flowers. His second foul. Stacy makes the free throw.
Stacy is the one guy.
He is the best free throw shooter.
He shoots 72% from the free throw line, which is pretty strong.
48-19, 49-19, 30-point advantage.
And Southern's still staying in their press, but they were looking to trap. Kidwell's just ready. He's on the mark there. He was ready to go if he turned his back a little bit more.
Massachusetts Southern lost last year in the first round to Massachusetts Central in an overtime game. So you know they'd love another crack at the Indians this season.
And Central is playing at a very high level right now. They've had a real tough schedule, and they've upset a couple of people, and they've also...
Kellen Miller gets it ahead.
Oh!
Michael tried to dunk. On the other way. Alexander with the basket.
Coach Bevin has got a little kick out of it. I don't know if Coach Jefferson is liking that too much or not. This is the time to try a dunk if you're going to try one.
Nice take by Tanner.
In this type of game.
Michael's probably like, I hope that camera up there from Madison County School Sports Television didn't catch that.
He was close. He was up there.
He got up. Foul on Gabbard.
Tate going back to the line. He's a good athlete.
Third foul on Griffin. As we're taping here on a Monday night, upset in the 43rd as Bryan Station girls have beat Scott County. I'm surprised by that outcome. 79-74, I believe, was the final. I'm a little surprised by that one.
Well, it's just what we've been talking about, you know.
District.
Everybody's prepared. You've had all this kind of time. They've known who they're going to play for a while. And
like you said, there's upsets every year in the opening round of district.
There is. Coach Buttry and Michael Jefferson getting a little bit of a laugh over there at the sideline. I'm sure they were talking about the dunk.
Burns drives, is fouled. He would be going back to the line.
Foul on Dalton Gadd there.
His third. Third foul on Gadd, and Alexander got a short rest. He'll be coming back in. Also another score note. My old boss Kent Miller won tonight. He beat Tate's Creek in the play-in game of the 43rd. His reward is getting to play the top team, Lafayette Lady Generals. Lafayette's a young team, but I think Lafayette can challenge Franklin County in the region come next week.
Well, Franklin County doesn't have a shoe-in. You know,
it's going to be tough.
They beat E-Town the other day, number one team in the state.
Yep.
But they've also...
I think they have some weakness.
They've been upset a couple times, too.
Yeah. They have one of the better players in the region, and Frank.
I'll tell you what's going to be interesting is the boys' side. There's so many teams that...
The 43rd has four top 25 teams in it. Two of them are going home.
That's the thing about it in the region.
43rd.
You don't have to
one district.
You don't have to be better than everybody in the region. You just have to be better than the ones you play. Well, that play was set up beautifully and just didn't finish.
Complete.
Nice pass.
Miller underneath, had it blocked.
Yeah, I'll tell you what.
5:27 left in the third.
Tanner really has a good open floor vision. He really sees things and gets the ball in the right place.
Short, nope, good. Tate gets it. Timeout on the floor. It's a 30. Let's keep it here. 52-23 now. As Tate gets his ninth point of the ball game.
Well, you'll probably see, since the game, the finals are on Friday.
Yes.
Coach Butcher will probably stay with his starters into the fourth quarter a little bit, but then you might want to try to get some of these younger guys some experience playing on this floor, have them, get used to this environment and this atmosphere a little bit. It's a lot different looking at it over on the bench than being out there on the floor. So,
you know, warm-ups doesn't give it justice. You know, it is a different floor.
This is a time to do it.
You know, in football, when a game's out of hand, I always like, you know, don't leave them in to get injured, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And in basketball, same way. Once you get a sizable lead.
It's the risk you take, you know.
And you I like to let my young ones get some play. And the thing is, a lot of these young kids will be needing minutes next year. They'll be getting some quality minutes.
Right,
so.
And to have the opportunity to play on this floor and
Kidwell, jump stop good.
Get that experience is valuable. Tanner's had a good, solid game.
9 points for Tanner. Well, they break.
Tip ball. Nice job by Berea. They're breaking that press. He had a nice cross-court
up ahead, though. Kidwell. Fouled. Good foul by Alexander. It's going to be a layup.
Nothing to lose there.
11 points for Tate now. So he got that last Berea basket.
That's just Alexander's first foul. They call that one four?
Wow.
I don't know about that. Looks like he was trying to get up. I think he's a shot there. Here's Kidwell running a little curl.
I thought it was a shot, but
little screen to screener.
Miller.
Nice inbounds play there. I like that.
You can get some points off good inbound plays.
I'll tell you what.
A lot of teams don't really worry about them inbounds as much. You can get 4 or 6 points, cheap points that
way. When I was coaching, we always had a scouting report, every out-of-bounds play that we had seen, and we covered it and how we were going to play it. And if you can just take away one or two baskets like that, you're going to win some games. You look at all the 1 and 2 point games there are. And
Guy Kandolfo was our scout from 99 or 2000, about 03, and he did a great job. He scouted the out of bounds play, like you said. You know, if you can take those away, those are easy points that can come back to hurt you at the end of a ball game.
Oh yeah, definitely. And Alexander got a full head of steam there.
And it's blocked.
Yeah, I thought he got fouled on the wrist.
Foul underneath. It's going to go against the Eagles. It's going to go against Kidwell.
That'd be a gut check if you were in there trying to take a charge from him. If he's going down to the floor a little bit more.
Big game like, you know, big the score like it is. Yeah, take that charge. 54-25, 4 minutes to play in the third. Stacy's down low trying to root him out of the block off the post.
Well, he did a good job there, too. Used his body and not his hands.
The switch.
Good hard hedge there on that screen roll. Same thing on this one.
Gabbard one-on-one.
Nice move.
Nice move.
Everything but the finish.
Back to Tate. Good. 13 now for Tate. He was running, though. Kidwell with the out. Gets out. Jefferson finds him.
Castle's got to get back right there. He's a point guard. That's his main duty. Unless they've designated someone else to be the safety man. Here's Tanner out again. Oh, nice pass.
Look at that look ahead. Got to get a timeout.
Oh, that is a great pass by Gabbard there with his left hand.
Oh, they just teed up. Number 42. They just teed up Gad. He said something or did something. I'm not sure. He must have said something.
Well, I didn't see it. I was looking down the floor. The
I was
way.
Too. But he must have said some magic words.
Well, the referee's talking to him right now about it. That's a learning experience there.
Southern emptying the bench here. Fives getting ready to come in.
Well, Gad's a senior.
Miller.
He should know better to say something.
60-27 now.
And Coach Butcher's going on to his bench.
He's saying,
heck
all
with
five.
This. Let's go ahead and
it's
get
getting feisty out there, to say the least. Last thing you need is an ejection.
Well, you got a 33-point game, and right, if you get thrown out of this one, you're sitting
done,
out of the district finals, and that's not good.
Subs in for Berea.
You got Eads there, number 23.
There you go. That's
Dean, 32.
Yep.
Got short, number 11.
Brandon Sargent with the three off the front.
And then, of course, Patel, number 24. Good job by Tate. I'll tell you what.
He's a hard-nosed little ball player.
He's had a nice game. He really has. He's competed the whole time.
15 for Tate.
You know, a lot of guys at this point, they get their heads down or whatever, but the Berea kids are playing. They're still playing hard.
31-point advantage. You know, Berea's probably playing not to go down 36 or whatever. They don't want no running clock.
Well, you're right on that. I'll tell you what. He's had a couple of plays here. He just done everything but make the layup.
Jump. Foul on number two, Castle.
Well, I know Eads is not going to back off from anybody.
Mm-hmm.
He's a football guy.
Yes, boy.
His dad played for me down at Southern, H.E. Eads. He was our leading scorer one year when he was a senior.
Bray is going to come out with a little press here.
You know,
31-point advantage, 2.5 to play in the third. Kid, young guy's going to get a lot of good minutes. Just touch it.
We got a turnover there.
It looks like they're going to get a quarter and a half out of it. So it appears Southern's going to get that opportunity at a rematch against Madison Central. Which everybody's expecting Central to come and win against Model.
If Madison Central wins tomorrow night, you can't take anything for granted.
No, that's Scott County girls tonight.
It would be a huge upset, though.
It would be one of the bigger upsets in the state. You know, last year we almost had it. Everybody was shocked by the Central-Southern game going to overtime last year.
Yeah.
Everybody except for Buttry and the Eagles.
Well, that was a gallant effort. There's Eads.
Three ball for the Eads.
Just like his daddy. His dad never saw a shot he didn't like, and he didn't hesitate either.
Eads is a great little football player, little running back.
Well, Nate is, like you said, on the football team, and after they won the district this year,
mm-hmm.
he was out on the field, and I was talking to him and his dad, and I said, you know, you two are the part of the only two district championships for Madison Southern's history. Nate for football, and H.E. was on the 95 team that won the district here.
Okay. The last time Southern has won the district.
Right.
Only time Southern won the district, isn't it?
For boys, yes.
Yes.
Girls have won it a couple times.
Girls beat Eagle Indians back in 07, I think, and of course last year they won for Coach Simmons' first.
Well, here's the
title.
Matchup right here.
Up off the glass, no good. To the line, though.
You got Patel guarding the quickest guy out there for Berea. And they recognize that, and credit to Tate, he went right to the rim.
Three fouls now on Patel.
We have some new kids coming in for Berea.
Well, 12 is going to check back in. Flowers. 10. Who's not on my.
David Gadd.
Okay, David Gadd. And what's the other? 21.
Conley. And we got another one coming in, too, number 5.
Caleb Conley checks in, number 21. And number 5 is Henry York. York is a freshman. He's a 6'5 freshman.
Well, you can't teach size. You know, you can improve your weight, but that height, that's all genetic. There's Eads again.
Patel with the offensive glass. Ball tipped. Sargent. No. Look at that.
What
Look at
play.
Short. Look at Short get up.
I'll tell you what, that is an impressive
Look
power.
Look at Sargent. And one. Brandon with the putback and the steal.
Well, I'll tell you what, that Short tip in, that's the play of the game right there. Back over his head. That was awesome.
And Brandon Sargent gets a turnover and basket. Go over the old fashioned 3-point play. 67-31.
Well, Short's just a sophomore, and he's 5'9".
Yep.
Really athletic tip there. And there's a sophomore matchup. David Gadd there, who we talked about earlier.
Next couple years.
That's got to be a charge.
No, it's going to be – oh! It was. I thought Sean might have reached in first. That's going to be the corner break.
Well, we got the running clock situation like you were talking about there. I don't even know if they realize it or not.
Well, they stopped the clock now at 5-6.
I wonder why.
I guess because they're going to inbound it. Like I said, it's inconsistent. They don't have the consistency on the rule. Short for a three ball.
Nope.
Way off the mark. End of three. Southern dominating 67-31. We'll be back for the fourth quarter and more stories after this.
Yeah, we need some time.
Thanks to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond, Jerry Goble and State Farm Insurance, Richmond, Express Roofing, we've got you covered, expressroofing.net, Cumberland Valley National Bank in Richmond and Berea, Luxury Pet Services in Richmond, Time Warner Cable, Equipment Sales and Rentals, Madison County Schools, Tatum Enterprises, and Real Life Community Church, My Real Church.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby.
Back to Madison County School of Sports Television. Fourth quarter about to get underway. Southern handily in control, 67-31.
We got some new kids in again for Southern.
55 is in.
55, Nathan Pruitt.
Steal by 55, Pruitt with the steal. Number two, that's McCreary, isn't it? Or McCreary.
33, Landon Stacy. He's a quarterback for the football team.
Yep, he's going to be playing quarterback next year.
Number two, Trey McCreary.
Yep, Trey McCreary. 55 got it in the post and broke the cardinal rule. He brought it down.
Should have
gone straight up.
Trey Boggs, number 22. Out here mid-court.
Yep.
So. And then you got Noah Marshall, who's been in the game previously. Number 14. And these guys, you know, we've talked about this before. They're being rewarded for all their hard work in practice. And
you know, that's one thing that a lot of people don't see. You know, when you go to a game on Friday night or Monday night, whatever, you see all the players on the floor. You don't get those guys at the end of the bench who are just working their tails off in practice.
Well, the varsity never reaches their potential unless they're being pushed in practice. And these guys, you know, they work against the varsity guys all the time. And they're playing JV minutes, but these are treasured minutes that they get right here. There's Dad.
Rebound it.
His dad actually teaches at Southern.
Nice follow by Pruitt. Couldn't get the fall. That wouldn't prove it. That's 33. Stacy, Landon Stacy. Up and in for number two, Castle. 6 points now for Castle.
He keeps attacking.
Yeah, Berea won't lay down.
No,
you know.
They got too much pride. This is a crosstown rival, you know, they're not going to sit there and get.
No, a lot of younger people are going to be like, Berea's never been any good, but. The Berea girls team many moons ago went to the Final Four of the state one year under Coach Greg Todd.
Yep. That was in the
it was like 96 or 97.
Good move again by Alexander.
Nice.
Just kind of muscled his way.
8 points for Alexander.
This is basically the JV team out here right now for Southern. And like we said, these are important minutes. You got the running clock situation.
Yes.
So,
And you know why they have the running clock. I mean, no doubt you've seen the news. 108-1 in a girls' basketball game somewhere. I mean, and as a coach, what are you supposed to do? You can't tell your JV team not to attack and play. You know, they're going to play.
Might be time to look at that program, see if they need to.
And that's another thing.
Back off a couple years and just have a feeder situation.
Stacy with the three.
And we got a
70-35.
We got a mammoth bench over here. Looked like Kidwell had fainted. They caught his body as he's passing out over here.
Stacy knocks down a three. I guess everyone was shocked. 5 minutes into fourth. But you're right, though. In the case of 108-1, maybe it's time to reevaluate athletics.
You know, I've seen.
You know, the state of Nevada now has a rule where you cannot beat a team by 50. If you do in girls basketball, anyway, now if you beat someone by more than 50, you must submit a report on how you tried to stop that from happening. Easy. Nice hustle there by both guys. Which I thought number 14 was going to wind up in her laps there. I was going to have Noah's way.
Noah's a big old boy now. He was coming after that ball.
I'm like, I don't have the ball.
I'd have let you take care of him. I was just going to get the basketball.
I was going to take charge. I had my arms crossed and everything. 4:10 to play in the fourth.
Good cut by Alexander.
And one. Alexander's a nice player.
Yeah, he does so many things for them. And, you know, this is his last hoorah.
He's got 10.
Tell you what, there's two of the worst things that you have to go through in coaching. One is to have to cut somebody.
Yes.
And the other thing is when that losing locker room last game of the year. There's only one team that gets to celebrate that last game, and that's a state champion. And all the rest of the people have to go through that process of,
you know,
coming into a locker room with tears. And
by the end of this week, there's half the teams are done. You know, over half the teams are going to be done.
That's right. That's too far. No, it didn't.
He got
it. Wow. That was a play right there. Now, Tate kid.
He's a wide receiver.
You could tell. I was just getting ready to say. You could tell he's a wide receiver in football. Sloan actually thought about a shot right there.
Out of bounds. Stays. Shot. Good.
Watch the bench here. See if we get the same reaction.
That's commonplace now. At the end of this game, we'll have a Jack Burford Chevrolet player of the ball game. Almost taken away by Dean. Dean thought he had a chance. Get back, young man.
Good play right there. Both ends there, Gadd and Castle teamed up. Really good ball movement. Good rebound there by Gadd in traffic.
2:20 to play in this one. Southern Advances championship game now, Friday night. Guaranteed a spot in the region. Lucky Southern, they're in the 11th region. Quite possibly the hardest region in the state, as we've always talked.
Well, there's many times when,
you know, I mean, you take it, like we just talked during the time hour before the break. In the 43rd district in the boys, there's four top 25 teams.
Yeah, that's
two of them are going home.
That's ridiculous.
Only two can come out of the 43rd.
Oh, okay, guys. Okay. It's all over.
Eads and Castle with the tie-up. We have a timeout, 75-41. We'll keep her here. And we're back to action. As we just really get to subs. If it does turn out to be the Madison Central, Madison Southern rematch, that should be an interesting one to see. As you said, Central's playing maybe as good as anybody right now in the region.
They're a hot team right now. You know, they almost upset Covenant Catholic the other day. They beat Trinity a couple weeks ago.
Eads with another one. Central has come to life with the addition of the big center for them, the Cozart kid.
He gives them another element, you know.
He wasn't around first of the year when we saw him.
Well, he's just a freshman, and yep. Boy, I tell you what, you think about what he's going to look like 3 years from now. He'd be a monster.
One minute left in this one. 80-41 is the final. Eagles have it. If they attack the basket, they do.
Oh, boy. We had the football team out there right now. Eads trying to put that up. Dean went up with one hand, almost pulled that in. Incomplete.
Both benches have been empty now as Tate and Alexander both come off the floor for their final time.
Well, congratulations to them for their careers. And
great career.
A lot of great memories. You know, it's a rough night tonight. When they look back a few years from now, they'll remember all the good times they had.
This is a tough district. Central, normally year in, year out, a pretty good ball club.
Dean's going to try to dunk this.
Yeah, he is. You knew that was coming. He said, screw it, I'll hit three. Boom!
Slowing. He's showing that quarterback touch.
Stacy with the basket. Long three. Get in there. No. Rebound. This one's over. 2-1. 83-41. Southern wins it going away. Dak Bufford, Chevrolet player of the ball game is Tanner Kidwell from Madison Southern.
Good, strong all-around game. You know, he did a lot of good things. Penetration-wise, nice assist, saw the floor, great court vision.
He made some great passes that should have been finished and were not. You know, kid's going to handle it, so.
Right. And he's a senior, did a good job defensively, and showed great floor leadership tonight.
83-41 the final. Tanner Kidwell, your Jake Bufford Chevrolet player of the ball game. Don Foster for Doug Sally, thank you for watching. Good night, everyone.
Have this presentation.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
We want to be sure and thank our fine sponsors, Berea Online, First Gear, WKYT.com, and the Colonel Sports Card Shop. Thanks to our other great sponsor, Kentucky Farm Bureau Insurance, Chris Hornsby. The following is in smokeless tobacco: cadmium, formaldehyde, lead, nicotine, nitrosamines, polonium 210, hydrazine, benzopyrene, and uranium 235. Don't be a dip. Don't dip.
According to the Centers for Disease Control, the definition of binge drinking is having 5 drinks over the course of 2 hours. When done excessively, this may eventually lead to memory loss, unwanted pregnancy, and sexually transmitted diseases, cancer, excessive vomiting, alcohol poisoning. And possibly death.
What's his name?
Nathan, can you hear me?
If you don't want to swallow any of this, chances are the next tube you put in your mouth won't be a good time. For more information on binge drinking, please visit the Centers for Disease Control website at www.cdc.gov.